Well, this is Dentsupply's new scanner. You can buy this as a digital impression system or pair it with a milling unit for a full CAD cam. So if you want to do in-office milling, hooked to a 3D printer, it's a fully open system. Some of the things that make this kind of stand out against other scanners on the market is going to be it's fully touchscreen. It's all cart driven, so the whole thing can be disinfected. No laptops to worry about getting dirt inside keyboards and things like that. The cart is, you can think about it like a rolling computer. It has a battery built into it that's going to last up to 4 hours in your office, which is great because you don't have to worry about trying to plug it into your outlet while you're using it. You can use it wirelessly and maybe just charge it over lunch a little bit to top it off for the afternoon. So it's going to be kind of like, you know, a pseudo wireless system. Other things about the cart, the main difference is going to be, like I said, touchscreen, a trackpad. So if you've seen some of the CEREC's of the past, they had a roller ball on here. It was tough to keep clean. Some people had a learning curve problem with that. This is going to be just like your computer at home. It has an oscillating lens built into the camera, so it's constantly gyrating while you're scanning. Some of the scanners in the past, you had to move it in different directions to capture everything about the teeth for clear aligner therapy, for example, all the embrasures of the teeth. This one's going to do that automatically for you. It has smart technology built into it that's going to be the, kind of like an artifact reduction. As you're scanning, and you'll see once we actually do the demo, when you scan things and you're, let's say their tongue gets in your way or something like that, uh-huh. The software within the camera is going to recognize that that doesn't belong there and it won't capture it.
Wow.
It can do similar things with blood. If you scan the prep already and starts to seep a little bit, it'll recognize that it's not there. You can pull the camera out and let it re-edit that back out for you, which is pretty amazing. No other camera on the market does that. Why don't we jump in the software so I can kind of see how it works. So this is the software, the CEREC 5.0 software. It's laid out to be very user-friendly to kind of lessen the learning curve. If you have new staff members, pretty much anybody can jump on here and figure it out. So you're only going to have two options down here, either add a new patient or show all patients. Adding a new patient is pretty simple. It's just going to ask you for some basic demographics of your patient, like a last name, a first name, date of birth. I like to keep that as today's date. It's date of birth of the crown, if you think about it like that. And we'll get out of here. And you could add a dentist name if you were in an office that, let's say, has more than one dentist. Okay. You want to track production by dentist. You could pull up and see how many cases each dentist did. And then if you think about this software, it's laid out five main steps: administration, acquisition, model, design, and manufacture. It's all the steps that you're doing right now if you're not using CAD/CAM. This system designs restorations three different ways. Biogeneric individual is basically like saying, computer, design me a crown based off of this patient's teeth. Biogeneric copy would be like a Xerox machine. A great example where you might use this biogeneric copy would be, let's say, a survey crown for a partial that has a clasp rest. If that tooth happens to be partially broken down, but the clasp rest area is still there, we could copy that area, and the machine just Xeroxes it, so their patient's not without their partial for three or four days. This might also work really well if you did a, let's say you did a wax up, and it was perfect. You got it just like you wanted, or you put them in temps for a while. You could copy all those temps or the wax up, and the machine will make a copy of those for you. Copy and mirror would be more for anterior work for the most part. It would be, let's say I'm restoring this tooth and I want to copy and mirror the contralateral tooth. And that way it gives you a really good starting point on your design. Down here is where you would select what kind of material that you would want to fabricate with the machine. What types of material do you use with your lab right now?
Mostly Emax.
Emax, okay. So you'll definitely have the option to be able to do Emax. These are all the different manufacturers of blocks in our system here. So if we wanted to choose Emax, for example, I could click on Ivoclar, IPS Emax CAD. That's going to be a CAD version of Emax, just like a lab would use if they're milling it, and very similar to pressables as well. You can also fabricate using things like full contour zirconia, and we have different lines of zirconia depending on the translucency that you want to have and the strength. You can do feldspathic porcelains, lithium disilicate like EMAX. Lithium silicate would be a block like Sultra Duo.
Right.
And then they have hybrid materials that are part resin, part ceramics. So a lot of different material options. Whatever you're using with the lab, you should be able to fabricate on here. Once you've made all your selections here, you'll have a next button down here at the right or at the bottom of the screen. You can click that. It's going to jump you to the next phase of the software, which would be where we'd take our digital impression. Mm-hmm. The camera system on Primescan is going to be always on once you get to the step from administration. And it has a motion sensor built into it. So as soon as you pick up the camera, it's going to realize that you're ready to scan something, and it's going to turn itself on. When you hang it back up, it'll turn itself back off. I'm going to show you how the 3D impression works, and we're already on scan. And you see where it says lower jaw. Uh-huh. So I'm just going to ask the patient, you know, open your mouth for me. We're going to isolate the prep just like you normally do with polyvinyl. So once you've either chose to pack cord or use a laser, or, you know, if it's super gingival, you don't need any of that stuff. In this case, that's what we got going on here. So we don't really need any isolation. We just ask that patient to open, slightly dry their teeth up. And then once you, like I said, once you pick up the camera, you're going to see it turns on automatically. It's ready to scan. You're just going to hover over the teeth a few millimeters, and you'll see it start to scan that part of the patient's mouth. And you can rotate it around different areas to get all the information you need.
Wow, that's fast.
It's very fast. It also is the only camera on the market that has a 20 millimeter depth penetration. And that's just a fancy way of saying that it can see a little bit deeper than almost any other camera on the market. One of my favorite features of the camera is the how it can basically get rid of ancillary data. So if I had my finger in the way, or let's say the patient's tongue got on the way, see my thumb, it's scanning it, but it doesn't keep that information. It realizes that doesn't belong as part of my digital impression, and it didn't keep any of that data.
Wow.
And that wasn't me cutting it out, that's just the camera recognizing that doesn't belong there. I like to hold it like as if you were holding a handpiece. So maybe down here on your metal sleeve there, just like that. That way you have an easy fulcrum on your fingers while you're scanning.
It doesn't matter what orientation this is, I can just get
no.
over it.
Yep, so, over but it I know you're gonna be, yeah, that side. And you hear that other audible tone there? That's telling you that the camera doesn't recognize where you're at, so you'll just like you did, you go back to an area that you've already scanned and it'll pick it right back up.
How far up do I need to go?
I usually like to go to at least the canine, and then if you're doing maybe more than one tooth, I'd probably at least go to the midline.
Am I done?
It looks pretty good. You can always, anytime that you feel like maybe I've got enough information for an opposing, you can take the camera out of the patient's mouth and rotate this around and see, missed some stuff on the facial surface there. So we'd want to go back and scan that.
Wow.
That looks perfect.
So you just stop, you put it down?
Yep, so as soon as you're done taking your scan, you can hang it back up in the cradle here, and you'll watch if you give it maybe about 2 or 3 seconds, it'll recognize that it's not in motion anymore and turn itself off. Can hit our arrow forward again, and that's going to jump us now to the next phase of the software. Right now it's going to think about all the pictures we just took. It's going to set our model axis for us, insertion axis is done for us, and assuming that our pictures are good, it will actually trace the margin for you on the software. So you can see here it's already got our finish line marked on the tooth. It's not any guesswork that we have to do. If we noticed if there was a problem, it was subgingival, I could then correct the margin if I'd like to, or if I was doing a bridge, I could alter pontic lines. Let's say if I wanted a ridge lap on the pontic or something like that, I could then alter that all in the model phase. If you look down here at the bottom, in software's past, these are all steps that you would have had to done. On the Primescan software, all those steps are completed automatically for you if you take adequate impressions. So once we've evaluated our margin, you can actually look at this as an impression too. You know, most dentists are used to looking at that more so than they're used to looking at that. So you can evaluate it both ways, and you can actually trace it both ways. So if you want to trace it as an impression, you're welcome to do that too. So once our model work, once we feel pretty confident with that, we can then move forward on the step here and you're going to watch the software is going to auto-design the tooth. Based off of all the other teeth that we've scanned in there, it's going to look at data, 3D data points on all the teeth and form fit a tooth number 30 that belongs in that patient's mouth.
And these are contacts?
Mm-hmm.
Is that what that is?
Yep, and you can actually turn contacts on for the entire model. So if I wanted to click model contacts, you could see how the bite might relate to the rest of the restorations. I think there's a prep above that one. That's why there's no contacts on mm-hmm. it. So you can kind of see how the patient occludes. This is usually the color scheme I use when I mill my restorations. In the software, there's going to be things you can set called parameters that kind of define how this restoration morphs in. So if you like tight contacts, or if you want pinpoint contacts on the occlusal, you can set all that for your initial proposal. Let's say maybe we decided that, you know, this facial side of the crown was bulbous and I wanted to bring it back a little bit. There's tools in here for me to simply click and drag on the tooth. And you can click and drag this and change it however you want it to look. You can change it to be a more circular area, so a smaller area. If I thought this contact was a little bit high, I could bring that down as well. I think that looks pretty good for a design. If there's anything you thought you would change about it, let me know. I mean, maybe this cusp is a little bit too high, bring that down just a hair. Marginal ridges both look pretty good. I call this my Connect hot link. Right down here it says Serona Connect. Once I open up this menu, I can click that. It's going to open this impression inside of our Connect software, so you then can just send that out to your lab. They have it in less than 2 minutes. So you could send that case, call your lab. Do you have everything you need to complete this case, yes or no, while the patient's still there? So you don't have to call them next week and say all the, you know, they didn't like the scan or something like that. So you can do all that. You can also use the Connect chat to chat with your lab that way. It's a pretty neat process. You can also export your files from right here. So if you wanted to export this model as an open STL file to 3D print it, you could do that right here, right from this step too. If you're happy with the design and you're going to fabricate it in your office, the design process is finished at this point. All we're going to have to do is hit that same arrow forward. And this is going to put it on our manufacturer tab. I don't believe this system is actually connected to a mill as we're just doing a demo here, but it's going to visually show you how it's going to position it inside the block. This little connector right here we call the sprue, that's just where the restoration is going to stay attached to the block in most cases. So there'll be a little connector you'll have to polish off before you finish the restoration. And you can change the position of that. So if the machine proposes it on a contact, let's say, we can move that around with a sprue tool and put it on the lingual.